News update at the hour. The weekend's with another homicide investigation after a 19-year-old was gunned down last evening. Police said the victim was driving east along Seabreeze Lane just before 9 p.m. when two gunmen in a dark-colored vehicle pulled up and opened fire, fatally wounding the young man before speeding off. Meantime, the body of a man believed to be homeless found through a tracked road off Carmichael this morning. Police say foul play is not suspected. And developers of Eleuthera's Jack's Bay development have so far invested more than $100 million in the luxury property, with phase one already complete. 100 people are working on the resort, with every expectation that that number will increase. That ends the ZNS News update at the hour. Once again, I'm Akushla Pinder. Good afternoon.
You're watching the ZNS Network, the People Station.
Oh no, we didn't know sex, I must be like this. Oh no, we didn't know sex, I must be like this.
Watch the people. Watch the masses. Everybody float. Watch the people float. Tell Mr. Johnson, bring a lady in red.
A class and a B class, everyone gets scared.
We ain't worrying about weather. We ain't checking for rain. No,
we ain't checking for sleeping.
Good afternoon, everybody, and welcome to beautiful Exuma. Yes, we are live here poolside at Peace of Plenty Hotel here in the heart of downtown Georgetown, and this is Regatta Time. I'm your host, Ricardo Lightborn, and it's a windy day, but a great day for sailing, as we had lots and lots of boats on the water earlier today. We had the Class E Series Race 2. We also had the Class C Series Race 2, and now the Class B on the water, and coming up a little later on, it's going to be the wonderful Class A. Two races will be back to back, all because of what we had yesterday. But last night, we had a chance to go down there to the park and go into the village to take a look at the shacks. I shouldn't call them shacks no more. The business establishments, they are. They were shacks years ago, but a lot of work has gone into making sure that that particular area, the park area down there, is unique, and it is unique. And last night, we had a wonderful time with the concert. Let me tell you, the British High Commissioner here for the first time took in Regatta. He comes from a sailing family. He promises me that he will learn how to sail and also take in all the regattas. And last night, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, he had a blast here in Georgetown, Exuma. Everyone having some fun conversations. These are what we refer to as really family affairs, and I like the word National Family Island Regatta. 67 years young, and has lived up to its billing accordingly. And right now, we have much going on over there, and our amigo Knowles is over there, and I asked him to stay on the land. Yesterday, he went on the sea. That's why we had bad weather. But right now, he's on the land. He's over there in Regatta Park. Ramiko, stay away from shack number 7, okay? That's where I'm coming when I get off air. Talk to me, man. What's happening over there tonight, today?
Hey, listen, I'm going to be by shack number 7, shack number 8, 9, 10, 11, and 12. I'm going to be everywhere tonight because this is where the action is happening in the Regatta Park. There may be some races happening in the water right now, but listen, right now we are having a ball at the Regatta Park here in Exuma for the 67th National Family Island Regatta. We had performances from electrifying artists last night. It had to be about 3,000, 4,000 to about 5,000 people out here last night. night enjoying themselves. And this is where it's all happening again tonight. I'm going to be joined now by one of the entertainers and also one of the organizers who helped put on those stage performances last night. A well-known entertainer in the Bahamas, the one and only D-Mac. Listen, last night was electrifying.
Listen, we've had two absolutely amazing nights. Wednesday and Thursday, they were absolutely amazing. We're closing down the site at 5 o'clock in the morning, so that is the type of energy that was out here for these last two nights. And tonight is going to be, I can't say what's going to happen tonight. Tonight is going to be crazy.
So with the people watching who are not here, what do you have to tell them right now?
Listen, all of the mailboats are coming. We have a party boat coming in. The party boat came in this morning. All the airlines are full. Bahamas Air has jets coming in. Western Air is putting on extra flights. I mean, it is absolutely amazing to see Bahamas come out and support culture, because tonight is an important night, because now we're announcing sailing as a national sport. And so to see the amount of persons that come out to support. So we have balance. We got the balance on the water. The first competition that's on the water, and now we see it on the line. Now we have the entertainment, so it's a great tie-in.
You have a horse out there or what?
Yeah, I got a horse in the race. A, B, and C. I can't really say, but hey, man, you know, I won't hurt too much of my other boys, you know, but I got a horse in the race.
Awesome.
Horse.
But who are some of the performances that will be performing tonight? We know some amazing Bahamian artists performed last night, and tonight is going to be the same thing.
Listen, we're doing the 50th, and so the idea is 50 entertainers and musicians on stage over 4 days, and that's what's going to happen. So tonight, last night we had an amazing night. I had a moment, my nephew sang last night, and I had a moment, I remembered my brother, but tonight is, you know, you got Lady E, you got the Geno D's, you got myself, you got Basil Smith, you got Nishi Ellis, you got Fanchon. Listen, the list goes on and on for tonight. And we wanted to do it in grand style. Because we're going live, we wanted to make sure that folks get to see that tie-in with sailing and entertainment and bringing everything at a high level, the top level.
High level, absolutely. There you have it. It's all happening here for the 67th edition of the National Family Island Regatta here in Exuma. If you're not here, listen, you are missing an amazing time. I'm having fun. I know Rick is having fun. We're all having fun. And listen, I'm going to send it back to you, but I'm going to get some more of the guests. I see the Minister of Sports is also here enjoying himself. He just came in off the boat, so I'm going to try to speak to him. But there's also a crowd of persons who are here enjoying the races. Going to speak to them, and we're also going to hear from some of the vendors here tonight, here this afternoon, who are selling some amazing food, which I'm going to try in just a few moments. But until then, back to you, Rick.
Let me tell you, man, thank you very much. But he did miss a entertainer, and that's going to be me and Hope Shelly Ann going to try to get in there tonight. Now, Hope and I had to leave early, primarily because we had to come back early this morning. But tonight, we're going to get out there, and Hope says she's got her act together. I got mine, so we're going to be rocking out there as well. Now, we did have quite a bit of sailing for you earlier today. Again, like I mentioned, we did have the E-class, and also we had the C-class that was sailed earlier today, which was kind of fun in terms of what happened there. And we had a lot of folks who came out here just to watch the races. We can tell you Captain P got the cannon in the E-class and the C-class. It was Sonia that also got the cannon there as well. And now the B boats are on the water. Folks are out there making sure that they enjoy the sailing. Yesterday was a day to remember, primarily because we had very good weather in the morning. And then, like in the afternoon, you see it now, it's nice and calm and cool. And then we saw some clouds that came through, and much, much happened then. They were on the waters, the Class A sloops, and very quickly things went from just sailing to something that really was kind of dangerous in more ways than one. Take a look. The E-class sloops went to the starting line for Series Race 1. Under great sailing conditions, Elizabeth Harbison, 23 sloops making a run at the national title. The small sloops with aggressive moves by the skippers and some counter moves to get the advantage. The call in the harbor is starboard. Yep, skipper and the bowman also, the calls led to success on the water. After an aggressive race, the Miss Agnes, and this is an Exuma boat sailed by Alton McKenzie, took the first cannon and now leads the competition. competition. Josh Green sailed the Aruba to a third place finish. And also right there is Andres Papa. Hey, looking good. Way to go, Douglas Saunders. The Lady L, Clayton Smith, also had a good run at it as well with a fourth place finish and some points for the Exuma boat. Buzzy Roll sailed the Man of War to fifth place. And also Sherman Brown, hey, he's in town. He got the gal also in the mix as well. Aaron Scavala sailed the Crooked Island Bird Rock to a seventh place finish. Baby Wave Judgment, Lady Kayla, all sending out calls that it's down to the wire and lots of sailing ahead. As far as the series race, this is a mouse and cat kind of scenario. We'll see how that goes. The Lady Sonia sailed by Buzzy Roll, took the early lead, and this one was kind of interesting, folks, and they kept the pressure on the sloops. Liam Brister Antoness also was not going to deny a shot at that title. That's a Rangan Island boat. Ackland's Barbarian was in the mix. Delworth Gibson in the competition. Ray Iguana Cobra sailed by Dwayne Higgins, keeping the family tradition alive. Stephen Kemp had the Whiplash in this one as well, trying to make a run in Class B. Old Boy, also Coachy Burrows with the title there. He wants to sail for Long Island and make a statement. And wow, the cannon could be in the bag. Buzzy Roll had the lead in this race on Lady Sonia and taking advantage of Class B. But the Lonesome Dove, the defending champion, representing Abaco, sailed by Jeff Gale, snuck right in there and took the cannon for first place. Terry Ann, after being repaired, sailed by Dallas Knowles, sailed a super race and picked up a third place. Dallas said it was a regatta and much more to come. We got 3 days of sailing. The Class A sloops went into the starting line. It was Ed Scott, Liam Brister as the skipper. Also, Keith Brown was sailing the Good News. New Courageous in Georgetown and making a statement. The new legend, always a threat to defend that 2019 championship. Red Stripe, a new look, new crew, and home water. Guess what? It was one for Rough Justice, who improved their reconfigured sloop, looking to combine and make something happen as far as they have already secured the Prime Minister's Cup. Running Tide is no slouch. And, you know, at Salt Pond, the sloop says, watch the back door. Anything can happen in a minute. The Tidal Wave is also back, and back in a big way, the Exuma favorite, and who knows what the 67th National Family Island Regatta will give them. The winds live with Elizabeth Harbor actually was simply a factor in Series Race 1. Gust winds over some 20 knots created a call by the race official. Clyde Roll said it was too dangerous to be on the water.
We got started, and about 5 minutes after we got started, the wind just came down, a squall built up, and the wind came down to about 38 knots. And we can't sail in that, and it got very, very dangerous out there. None of the boat were able to tack, and it got dangerous. So I consulted with the race committee, and they said it would be the safest thing was to call that race off. And so that's what we did, and all of the sailors except one said we should continue, but, you know, for the safety of all of the men on those boats, we decided to call the race off because they could not finish the race in that type of wind. So I thought the decision of the committee was the proper decision to make, and I think 99% of the sailors, I think, would agree that was the right decision to make.
The A-class is stacked and up for grabs. No talking, just a lot of sailing. Let me tell you, that was a crazy, crazy day yesterday, but today is a whole lot different. They're going to have two Class A races that's going to be coming your way. We now have with us a very special young lady who is having her hands full with things happening. She's in charge of cultural and also authentic events here in Exuma, and that is Charity M. Brister. We were talking earlier, and she says she hasn't cooked for the week yet. She is promising us breakfast tomorrow morning. Just kidding. Charity, how are you today?
I am just fantastic. Good. How are you doing?
I'm great. Tell me about the regatta so far. You've been around and looked at what's happening down in the park. You've seen what's happening all throughout the island. Give me your take on where we are at this point. How you feel things are going?
Things are going very well, I must say. And like you've mentioned, and I saw last night, it was epic at the site. Mm-hmm. And when we think about regattas and festivals, I like to say that's domestic tourism at its best. We see the thousands of people coming in. I understand Bahamas Air has like maybe 5 flights today. And of course, more persons will be coming tomorrow. And then people are coming by boat, you name it. And it's just a great way of Bahamians getting together, celebrating our culture, and sharing it with our visitors.
And the Ministry of Tourism has done a great job at that. We saw and spoke to earlier some visitors that are here and actually sailed all the way down from North Florida.
Yes.
And has come down, and they've actually been here now for well over a week. And you've had that kind of business and events for them from the Easter break.
Absolutely. And talking about boaters or cruisers coming from north, we had recently the cruising regatta.
Mm-hmm.
There were over 375 boats in that harbor. So when you're on the mainland, Exuma, and you look over, it looks like a city at night. And a lot of those persons remain after their cruising regatta. They hang around for the National Family Island Regatta. And then some hang around as long as enough time to even maybe take a little peek at the Long Island Regatta. So sailing and cruising is very popular for the Exumas.
Mm-hmm.
And of course, you know, what a better place to be than in Elizabeth Harbor.
And that's an ideal spot for sailing. Also, we got the impression that a lot of visitors who want to come can't come because everything's overbooked.
Absolutely.
And if you didn't book from last year,
you're
in trouble.
Big trouble. In fact, even for the Bahamian Music and Heritage Festival that took place last month, it was quite a challenge. One or two properties were closed, and then they got some rooms ready for us. Major property that we would normally put some of our staff and entertainers was off limits because we have persons who are in Exuma for long term, like persons working on the roadworks or the airport,
right,
or just coming in to build. And so there is a little challenge here, and Exuma can really use another one or two small boutique properties, but I must give it to the Exumians. They have taken the opportunity to venture into Airbnbs. And so Airbnbs in Exuma is not just the second homeowner or the foreigners. A lot of Exumians are tapping into that now. And that looks like that's the way we have to go now.
But I'm seeing a lot of construction as well, which says much about what's happening. So
absolutely,
a lot of folks are deciding that this is a business hub now.
It certainly is. And this, Exuma really could and should be the hub for the Southern Islands, you know. As you would have seen driving up and down, there's construction
everywhere. Agreed.
And jobs, there's no one on Exuma who's looking for a job and wants to work who's not working. You know, people have 2 and 3 jobs because jobs come also with the Airbnbs.
Right.
You have cooks, you have the housekeepers, you have the gardeners, the maintenance persons. It's like, it's really booming here. And so we need to, I think, instead of trying to catch up, try to get ahead of everything in terms of service. And talking about service, we at the Ministry of Tourism, we are organizing a special training for restaurant workers in particular.
Right.
Because that is really a deficiency. And I hear it all the time. I experience it all the time. And so, therefore, we are starting some training as early as the second week in May.
Well, that's important, and I know that's going to be an added dimension to getting your visitors to come here, because when I looked, when we came in, the airport with its new with expansion project is going on. You have these new properties that's coming on stream, and so they're looking at Exuma and these keys as the next gateway for a lot of individuals.
Absolutely.
And folks, I don't care how far north you are, you're coming down here because, again, you would like to present that hospitality and that native touch and flair. And that's and that's an added dimension that Exuma gives you.
It does.
You know, besides the pristine waters and the beautiful landscape.
Yes, it's the people. And I take time to browse the exit surveys and the comments, just about every one of them, they talk about the people being so friendly and how they just love the people of Exuma. And having said that, on the flip side, we get the good and the bad. Mm-hmm. And one of the things that's very concerning is the amount of litter. And so, you know, we have something here that we should treasure. And some people are not doing that. And, you know, it's not good when the visitors come to your shores and they're going to tell you, oh, you have a beautiful island, but it's filthy. Or, you know, and, you know, they're driving up and down and they can
see
the litter.
The stuff that's on the road.
And so we as a people need to take care of what we have.
And I tell you, driving in and out of Georgetown and moving around is a pleasure. Compared to years ago, the paved roads and,
the roads
and everything else. And only one thing, though. This is not the expressway in Florida.
No, that
is not as often. They got to slow down, man.
They drove like that before, when the roads were not as good. So you can imagine now, right? It's like, oh, wow.
You know, because I go walking and early in the morning, right? I know you got to get to work on time.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, but,
you need
to get to work.
That.
All right, because if you keep going the way they were going and past me and you know, walking in the morning, it was crazy.
Yeah. And especially this weekend, you know, there's so many persons who are not familiar with the road.
Mm-hmm.
And there's so many curves. So people really need to be very careful. I mean, I'm sure you will see one or two cars off the road in the bushes because they're going around these curves at such high speed. You don't know this road. So, yeah, we encourage people to drive safely and have a safe regatta.
You know, we want everybody to be safe whilst they're here.
Yes.
And I think that's great. And we had to tell our driver, Julian Anderson.
Julian.
See the curve?
this is just how the road is.
I tell you.
Yeah.
But, you know, the hospitality and the new innovations and the new introductions of restaurants and other properties here to Exuma, whether it's east or west, is really paying dividends. We have a piece we want to show you why going west and going all the way down there near, even to Williamstown, is worth the trip.
It certainly is.
Let's see.
Our inspiration really came from a very simple background. Our objective was just to provide a comfortable dining space for us as Bahamians, as well as tourists. But it was just to provide a nice, comfortable ambiance, good food, a place you can really enjoy dining. We actually are a regatta baby. We were born 7 years ago, during the week of regatta, exactly. And just hard work. It grew really rapidly. You know, God is good. We grew very rapidly. And dedication to whatever your craft is. We've been dedicated to this restaurant from day one. Lots of hard work, lots of long hours. COVID was very difficult, as it was for everyone. We just did a lot of pivoting. You know, when we were allowed to do takeout, we did takeout. When we were allowed to do outdoor only, this is where this deck covering came from. We have some cabanas on the lower level. Those were created during COVID when we were only allowed to do outdoor dining. We came up with the concept of dining al fresco, you know, dining privately and individually. So we did a lot of pivoting during COVID, and we survived. Well, our original plan for this property always included venturing into some accommodations. We have the first of four cottages completed already. And we find that during our busy season, our peak season, we tend to run out of a lot of indoor dining. It's the islands, mosquitoes get bad. There are points and times when everybody wants to sit indoors. So we added additional indoor dining, which is also used for larger parties. You want to have a private birthday, you want to have an anniversary party, a business meeting, we've added an additional room for that. There isn't a day really that I drive over this hill and I look at this view and it becomes normal. I always say that this is the most beautiful place on earth. And I haven't been everywhere on earth, but I can say that with confidence because Exuma is one of the most beautiful places on earth. So I try to take time to relax and reflect and just appreciate, you know, what's been afforded.
What a wonderful setting that is to have a blue water down there and see what they've done. And even though it's outside of Georgetown, people are coming from far and wide to go to that particular restaurant.
It has certainly taken off, very popular, good food, and people just want to go there, have a drink. That view alone, you know. I said the other night there was a group here that I was welcoming, and I had to refer to the comments by Scott Kelly, the astronaut, who tweeted, of course, again, that Exuma has the most breathtaking waters. And Exuma is a very easy sell, you know, so it's not a lot that we have to do, but we just need to do what we must. We have the basic product in terms of the waters and of course the added swimming pigs, you know.
There
people
you go.
Just come to Exuma, just see the swimming pigs. They want to experience that. And so that's been very popular as well. And so we just need to continue to provide the additional amenities, stay on top of our game, and keep pace with what is happening in Exuma. The other morning, I went to the gas station, and I was on the gas station line for 45 minutes to an hour. Now, figure that.
Okay. You almost ran out of gas.
I could have. If I had waited longer.
Right, and that's another addition
there,
that
know?
We need to see.
So
you know,
it's things
like that,
yes. And even like, you know, Exuma is no longer this little sleeping community.
No, it's a
and
big
And so, I think everybody who is in business, you might want to keep it special to a certain extent, but we have to keep up with what is really happening. And so, I don't know, maybe the gas stations need to stay open a little longer. Don't close at 6:30 at 7 o'clock.
I think what has to happen.
And so these are the things that need to come.
Okay. Well, you got your work cut out for you, and you're doing a very good job at this juncture. And we can hope to see some other expansions in terms of what happens here in Exuma. Please do keep the nice, quaint situations but you need to also provide that those services that's necessary, and also get those restaurant workers in your program, get them going, because service is number one.
Number one.
We want to make sure that happens, and we want to thank you for all of your assistance here whilst we're here in Bimini. In Exuma.
That's okay.
Yes. People in Bimini Sig, I want to lay low. Stevie, they can lay low.
Thank you very much.
Stevie, I lay low in Exuma, bro. Okay. Let's take a break. We'll be right back here as we have Regatta time in Georgetown, Exuma.
They call them the barefoot bandit. This boy, you know, he was a fool. They call them the barefoot bandit. Centuries, Bahamians have been known as masters of the sea, from the Lucayans and Arawaks, swashbuckling pirates, quaint workboats to meticulously crafted sloop race boats. Bahamians have evolved the sport of sailing as it plays an integral part of our culture. For more than 70 years, Bahamians have displayed passion and grit for the sport, and it is one that has bridged the gap between young and older Bahamians. We are proud to anchor sailing as the national sport of the Commonwealth of the Bahamas.
Are you overpaying for low speeds with your internet provider? Stop wasting your money. Switch to BTC for the fastest internet to the most homes in the Bahamas. Get up to 300 megs fiber fast speeds, up to three times faster than what you get now. Plus, get 164 TV channels, all for just $42.50 a month for 12 months. That means you'll save $860 for the year. For the fastest speeds across the Bahamas and the lowest price by far, BTC is for you. Switch to the largest fiber network in the Bahamas.
Sand Dollar is the digital dollar created by the Central Bank of the Bahamas. It's just like physical cash, but safer and more convenient. Sand Dollar is secure and can be used on any Android or ISO device. Use Sand Dollar for your personal and business transactions. Whether by QR code or short name, you can send or receive Sand Dollar safely with the touch of a button. Download any Sand Dollar-enabled app to get started today. Sand Dollar, it's just like texting cash.
Isn't a home without the perfect furniture. The perfect furniture starts with Security Depot. With so many styles of sofas, sectionals, and bed sets, we make your dream home possible without burying your wallet. We also carry the best brands and appliances like Samsung, Frigidaire, and Emerald Chef that will make you love coming home. Visit our furniture showroom at the Mall at Marathon today or visit our website, securitydepot242.com. Endless possibilities are at Security Depot.
242 Prime Spirits now has its newest location in Farmers Hill, Exuma. Need an ice cold beer? How about some miniature wines, smooth rums and bourbons, or sparkling champagne? 242 Prime Spirits in Farmers Hill has all of this and so much more. Open Monday through Saturday, 9 a.m. to 6 p.m. Call them at 358-7055 to pre-order or with any special requests. Check out 242 Prime Spirits on Facebook and Instagram for more info or email them at 242primespirits@gmail.com. 242 Prime Spirits, now in Farmers Hill and Georgetown, for all of your beverage needs.
Jolly agreeable, need it daily now. Get a sailor man sound. Crawly gray, your boat needed daily now.
And welcome back, everybody. Yes, this is Regatta Time. We're live right here in beautiful Georgetown, Exuma. This is the Peace and Plenty Hotel, and we're here poolside as guys are out here watching the Class B race that's ongoing right now here in Georgetown. We had earlier the Class E. We also had an opportunity to see the Class C races, and also right now the B. And then we got a unique race for you coming up later on. That's the Class A, and we're going to have actually two races because of the high weather winds that came up yesterday, so we didn't want to have any issues, and so we wanted to make sure we're able to get that done. But the guys had a couple of good days of sailing, and even today, good days of sailing. The Terry Ann, as you can see here in the water, had a mishap during the cup races on Wednesday, but there it is. The guys from Abaco and right here in Exuma all pinch hit and made sure that they got that boat right back in the water, the Lonesome Dove. And so, you know, it's kind of an interesting scenario out there, and this is not child's play. You have to be very, very consistent and understand the rules of sailing. And one of the guys who knows about the rules of sailing is one of our honorees, and that is Mr. Michael Copey. I got it right?
You've got that right.
There you go. Mr. Michael Copey, who was on the committee and has been doing quite a bit of work. He's been on the water since we got here, watching him on Wednesday and Thursday. He's been out there doing his due. And for you, how do you feel about where we are at this point?
I think we're in a good place. I think so far the regatta has been great. The unfortunate incident that happened out there, it was an amazing testimony to sportsmanship in the Bahamas. Mm-hmm. And I hope it continues like that for all the rest of the regattas. It's an important thing if sailing is going to be the national sport. Especially in the international community, mm-hmm. that the Bahamian sailors represent themselves in a like manner. And nothing does it better than what you saw yesterday when the boys from Lonesome Dove worked on
Terri-Ann.
Yeah, to get it fixed up for this morning.
Okay. And also keep in mind, too, that with this new responsibility in terms of the national sport also puts a lot of responsibility on the committees like the National Family Island Committee, which you are a part of, in order to ensure
right.
that there is safety on the water.
That's right.
And that there's also safety on the land.
That's absolutely right. And for the committee, you're always in a difficult position because you can't please everyone. So if there's a judgment call that has to be made out on the course or a call that's made in a protest, someone's going to be unhappy. But what I've learned over the years is that, fortunately, the unhappiness only lasts for a short time, and then people are your friends again. So you move on, and you wait for the next race and look forward to getting into it and sailing again.
Now, you sit on the committee, that appeals committee. And yep. there's been plenty of them so far in terms of what's happening
well,
in the race.
Well, but remember, the appeals judge only comes into play after a protest has been heard.
Right.
And if one of the participants in the protest is unhappy. For many years, I was the protest committee chairperson. And finally, I said to Danny, I had enough of that. I said, I don't like ruling against my friends. It makes it very awkward for the short time that I'm here. But I don't know if it was 15 or 20 years after I first became the chairman.
And for you to be honored in this edition, the 67th edition, and the layoffs that we've had, how do you feel about what's being placed on you as far as this week?
Well, I'm very honored to be honored. I told Danny when he called me, I said, I don't need to be recognized like this. I said, what I enjoy the most and what honors me is being able to come down here to the Bahamas and be a part of the committee and all the friends that I've made and continue to see every year. I mean, it's like old home week walking through Main Street here. Everybody, hi, Mike, how are you?
That's another thing that I saw when you were coming off the boat and the sailors came up to Regatta Point and the kind of greetings
yeah.
that was given to you.
It's very warm. I mean, I had many people who quickly became my friends. And then afterwards, when I married my wife, who's from Exuma, mm-hmm. and Jen Dames, all my friends became my cousins. And I like that because I like the Bahamian people.
And I was laughing because when you said that, and Jen has also been involved with this sailing. Yeah. And so you guys should have some very good conversations in the afternoons, man.
Well, she doesn't sail. She likes the committee work. She likes the involvement with the people.
Mm-hmm.
But a sailor, she's not. So the first time that she came to Boston, I chartered a boat, and we went up to Maine, and we sailed the waters. And she said, you know, I don't really like sailing. But we eventually got a powerboat, and now we cruise the waters in the powerboat. Mm-hmm. And she likes that. So,
for you, when you first started sailing, why?
I was always interested in sailing and in building a boat. And when I was 15 years old, I remember as a young boy saying to my father, after we would go camping and spend the summer on the beach, Dad, can we get a boat? And my brother, who was only a year and a half younger than me, said the same thing. Every year, my dad would take us out and we'd look at this boat. And what I didn't realize is our parents didn't have the money to buy a boat. But eventually, my brother bought the first boat, and the first boat was just a little 14-footer called a International 14, I think it was called. That.
Mm-hmm.
And we sailed that, and then I eventually got a boat, and then I bought that boat from my brother, and then a good friend of mine who I worked with, he said to me, Mike, he said, I've been looking for a partner for my boat. And I said, George, it's interesting that you're asking me to be a partner, because I was going to ask you if I could be a partner.
There you go.
And so I became partner in a cruising boat, and then just things went along. My daughters decided they wanted to sail from Cape Cod down to Trinidad, so I helped them fix up their boat. They sailed in Kahtuwit and raced a little 14-foot boat called the Kahtuwit Skiff.
There you go.
And so sailing, it had a natural progression, and it's always been a lot of fun.
Mike, I can put you on the spot. The water in Boston or the water in Elizabeth Harbor?
The water in Elizabeth Harbor. No question about it. You're not putting me on the spot. When I came down on the barge on Monday and we pulled into Elizabeth Harbor, I was in the back of the Defense Force barge, and as I looked out, I said, I know we're in Elizabeth Harbor, because this blue is different than any other blue, even in the Bahamas. And I've cruised up through the Exumas. I've been over to Long Island. And I don't care what you say, there's nothing as pretty as this harbor.
And I tell you, this natural harbor is the ideal spot for sailing. And we've seen since we've been here from Sunday that there is a consistent breeze that blows through here, and that is what is needed.
That's
and
right.
Then also the water isn't that deep that it could take the A boats, it could take the B, take the C and E. Anything happens, they can actually float the boat and not have to worry about it and don't have to lose
it. They can lift it if they have to. Yeah.
So, and planning this, and when you looked at the years gone by, this was an ideal spot for the National Family Island Regatta.
Well, I mean, when I first came, that's what I was told.
Right.
As I've moved around the Bahamas a little bit, I realized that this is the best spot for the National Family Island Regatta. I mean, I can't imagine. It wouldn't be the same if it were in Nassau.
No.
I've been to the Black Point Regatta. It's not the same there. It wouldn't be this, even Long Island, which they talk about as being a great regatta. A great regatta it may be, but this place is beautiful. And the only problem that we have here is if the harbor were a little bigger, you could have longer courses.
Right. But what it does, though, is that it also brings the sloops right up near the shore.
Right.
And so you can see exactly what they're doing.
Absolutely right.
And so you can get you can go to the tower, sit down, and listen to the would-be skippers.
Yep.
And everybody on the tower is a skipper.
That's right.
Making all kind of noise and talking about what the sailors should have done and what they should have, what they shouldn't have done, and all this other kind of stuff.
Right.
So the stories are many.
There are many stories, and it's always interesting after a race to hear them rowing with each other. but it's what I love about the Bahamian people is they can row, whether it's about sailing or whether it's about politics, but they stay friends.
Absolutely.
Yep, and I think that's a wonderful trait.
And we just saw that, Mike, earlier today, when we had right after the E class and the C got ready to go, there was the sailors trying to get to their boats.
Yep.
And they're being shuttled back and forth by the other little small tenders. And, you know, they're fussing on the shore and talking about what they're going to do. You know, I can beat you so bad until you cry. I'm like, and these guys are going out here on the water.
Right.
But that's the love of this sport.
Yes.
And I tell you, that's fantastic.
Yeah, I think it's wonderful. It's a great opportunity for young people and older people who aren't diplomats to practice diplomacy.
And we saw that earlier.
Yes.
Okay. And that's all because we did also have the Minister's Challenge for Clay Sweeting. Also, Chester Cooper went out there.
Yes.
John Pender and also Wayne Monroe.
Right.
Our ministers went, and they call themselves sailors.
Right.
Okay. And so they went out there and said, we'll show that later on. We don't want to start a fight here.
But I think they did a great job out there. They went out, and there's only a couple of them that have sailed the sloops before, I think. And they did a whole course. I thought it was just going to be a windward leg, and they'd finish it at the windward mark.
Right.
But they did. They did an up-down course and then over to the government dock, so the spectators got to see
them,
it.
Work the boats and go from there.
Yeah.
And also, I saw in the E-class a lot of young sailors.
Yes.
You have a vibrant sailing club here in Exuma, and it's worked wonders. And we saw last night where the British High Commissioner is interested in youth sailing.
Yes.
And he was here just to watch and make sure. And I'm going to tell you, they're going to be coming for these little small guys who are maneuvering these boats and moving up from the E-class and up into the C-class, and so things are going to move in the right direction.
Well, that's how Stefan Knoll got his start. when the first years that I came down here, he was a little kid, and I can remember seeing him on the bow and meeting his family. Mm-hmm. And Clyde and I talked, and we decided that we should have a scholarship program and take the winner of the children's race and bring them up to Cape Cod for a summer and let them sail up there and race with the kids. And Stefan came up there, and not only did he race, but he won the club championships in Cotuit, Massachusetts, which was pretty amazing because he got into the boat for the first time.
And that's what this is all about, is about passing on the tradition.
That's absolutely right.
So you're pretty much so happy where we are at this point with sailing?
Yeah, I'm happy. I'm sure there'll be changes, and they'll all be for the better. The one thing that I've always pushed Danny on is trying to adapt more of the international rules, and I know that that will come with time, especially with this younger generation coming up, because they learn by the international rules.
Right.
When they sail Opties, they sail international rules. Yeah. And it's a little different with the sloops, but it'll change.
Right. And also the lasers are...
The lasers are international rules.
So we look to see our kids. And then, you know, you can move to the Olympic level, the world championships, and all these other kinds of championships accordingly.
Well,
and
Sir Durward Knowles was a star... sailor. He was an Olympic champion too.
That's right. Yeah. So we got some stars and gold medalists that could probably find right here in Exuma and Ragged Island and Long Island and various other islands of this country and Andros and all over.
Yeah.
So we'll see how that goes.
I think it'll be a great thing for the Bahamas, and I mean, this is a natural place to have sailing be the national sport.
There you go.
Yeah.
Did you bring your tuxedo from Boston?
No, I didn't. I didn't bring my tuxedo.
Hold on, Mike. No. Mike.
I didn't even bring a tie.
Mike, how are you going to get your award? You don't have your tuxedo, man.
Well, I said to my wife, I said, Jen, look, every time I've been down there, it's been casual.
Right.
I've never buttoned the collar at my neck, and I'm not going to do it for the award ceremony.
There you go. And tonight we're going to have the ceremony to name sailing as our national sport, and then we'll also have the final day of races tomorrow. I know you'll be out there all day. You're going to head out there, too, with the Class A sloops. You got back-to-back races.
Absolutely, yeah.
And so you'll be up there on the bow, and we'll see how you move around. Yep. And then on Saturday, final day.
I have the committee's phone number, so I can call them, and they can come pick me up.
There you go.
Right here.
So you ready to go to see what happens out there in the water?
I'm ready to go.
There you go. Let me tell you, Mike is the one special young man. Let me tell you, this has been great just to talk to you. You know, we met up there at the Regatta point, but to see where we are at this point, we want to thank you for your many years of service.
Well, thank you very much.
I need you to talk to Danny. Okay? Just tell Danny point blank that it ain't over yet. Until it's over.
Okay. I'll tell him that.
Let him know, okay?
Yeah, all
and
right.
He knows exactly what that means.
Okay? All right, okay.
But I know there is a new wave.
That's a Yogi Berra quote.
There you go.
Yeah.
You got a number of young people that's going to be a part of the sailing committee and also moving over. They've hinted that Dallas Knowles is sitting in the waiting, whatever, because I spoke to him yesterday.
Uh-huh.
He was a bit dampened by the fact that the boat got damaged, and now that he got it fixed and he's sailing, he's now brought that energy level back up. He's motivated, and he's got the junior sailors all working, and so that's a good fit.
One of his junior sailors is actually going to school in Massachusetts, and he's my wife's cousin's son, Delano Bow, and I see him, and we talk about the sailing all the time.
What you mean, the wife? Cousin son. That's your wife. That's your cousin.
That's my cousin.
That's your cousin.
Yeah,
get it right, Mike.
I know.
That's your cousin, right? There you go, ladies and gentlemen.
It's like I talk about Jen's daughter, and sometimes I say Tatum, sometimes I say stepdaughter, and Jen looks at me and she said, she's your daughter.
That's it.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
Yeah. And it's amazing. She said, she's down here, and she said, well, I'll come by the room and see you. And of course, she's been so busy with her friends, I haven't seen her. I said, she's young and having a good time. That's what life is all about.
Let me tell you, Mike, it's been a pleasure
to
see you.
It's really been nice to talk with you.
I want to say congratulations on being recognized.
Thank you very much.
As a part of the committee and the many years you've put into this. And tell Jen that Exuma still has the best sailing anywhere, even though she's in Boston.
Right.
This is still home.
She knows that.
Okay.
Yeah.
And he can wear short pants. And you know that funny weather up there in Boston?
Yeah.
She's getting paid back for leaving.
But she tells me she likes cold weather.
Say what?
She says she likes cold weather.
Mike, tell that woman.
Yeah.
She needs to come back here.
I know.
And take a dip in this water. Yeah, okay?
Right.
Okay. There you go.
All right. Thank you.
Say hello to Mike. He's going to be on it tomorrow night right here, and we're glad to have him with us. We are at Regatta Time live here in Peace of Ben. Here are the guys in the back is talking smack, waiting for the Class A sloops. We got a whole lot more ahead. Stay right there.
Today is a day for fun. Today is a day for family. So why should yesterday's worries affect my today? That's why I insure my family with J.S. Johnson, because their mission is to provide us with the best insurance coverage possible. With J.S. Johnson, I know my family comes first, so I take comfort in knowing that they always have us covered, providing us with a great today and an even better tomorrow.
J.S. Johnson Insurance Agents and Brokers, giving you peace of mind.
All the electronics you need are at Security Depot. Laptops, cameras, speakers, TVs, drones, video games, and so much more are here at Security Depot. Check us out at the mall at Marathon to see our wide selection, or visit us online at securitydepot242.com. Endless possibilities are at Security Depot.
First we plan, then we innovate, then we build. At Bahamas Striping Group of Companies, we are committed to quality, to safety, and to service. We know that the road you take is just as important as your final destination. At Bahamas Striping Group of Companies, it is our job to make sure the road and the ride are as smooth as possible. From striping roads to building them, we are the right choice, the trusted choice, the only choice to help you build your tomorrow.
To drink responsibly.
We get up early every morning to offer safe and dependable service. Where quality service is paramount. An excellent travel experience is priority. Connecting the islands of the Bahamas to the world. Bahamas Air. We don't just fly here, we live here.
242 Prime Spirits in Georgetown, Exuma is your one-stop shop for all your beverage needs. From ice-cold beers to wines to rum and sparkling champagne, they've got everything. Open Monday to Thursday, 9 a.m. to 6 p.m. and Friday, Saturday, 9 a.m. to 7 p.m. Call 242 Prime Spirits at 336-3728 or WhatsApp 823-9388 for special requests, to pre-order, or for delivery. Be sure to ask for Magnolia or Kelly. And check out their Facebook and Instagram pages at 242 Prime Spirits for more information. That's 242 Prime Spirits, Georgetown, Exuma, and now at Farmers Hill for all your beverage needs.
Thank you.
Welcome back, everybody, to beautiful Georgetown in Zuma. Yes, the 67th edition of the National Family Island Regatta. We're into the series races here. Earlier today, E and C, B still on the water, and still to come is the Class A, and folks are really gathering like crazy to make some things happen. And it's time now for us to go to our Big Splash Regatta giveaway code, and so here we go. Remember now, let me tell you that once you in turn see the code today, you need to go to ZenithBahamas.com, enter the word and your information so you can make sure that you get the daily code and put it in so you can be eligible to be a big-time winner. Now, the code is going to come up, and once you get it, go to ZenithBahamas.com, put the code in and information. Ready for the code? Here we go. Okay, now that you have the code of the day, the Big Splash Regatta giveaway word right now, make sure you go to ZenithBahamas.com and put the code and your information in. And then once you are eligible, you'll be able to win some big prizes. Let me tell you, you can get cell phones, compliment of a BTC, cases of Cuba Libre, and also you can get a free credit on your Sand Dollar wallet, and also you can get a ThinkPad courtesy of Security Depot. So make sure you stay with us. Tomorrow we'll be back here live again from 2 to 4 p.m. and we'll give you the code and you can put in the 3 and then you can win some pretty good stuff here, and it's going to be fantastic. Don't forget to go to ZenithBahamas.com, put the information in, and you could be a big winner. We've had a wonderful morning here in terms of watching the races, and also had opportunity to go over to the Georgetown Primary School, and right next to the Georgetown Primary School is a wonderful place. They have a library, but in the library there are some interesting things. I called Ramiko and said, listen, see what's going on inside. I saw some things that I believe are historic in nature. Here's Ramiko with that report.
This is Georgetown Public Library, where history comes to life. Within the library's walls lie remnants of yesteryear, including artifacts used by skippers from bygone eras. While the exact date of the library's construction remains a mystery, it is estimated to be over 80 years old.
When you say way back in the day, how long are we talking?
I don't even know. But I know I used one or two of the items, which is the enamel pan, the cup, and the goose, and the pot. And you put on the whole file, so I know about those. Mm. And the oil lamp.
And these are actual pieces from during the time when Regatta started?
Yes, I believe so.
Okay.
Use this pot on the three legs. Yeah. This is on the file side. We cook that smoked peas and rice. Or soup, dumpling soup. Then I smoke getting that food, you know, that's the best food to eat there. This is the fine one used to cook. This fry is the best fish on the file side. I think it still sells them now. And I use the goose iron, put it on the fire, get the brown paper, but put it on the brown paper and then you iron the clothes. Used to this.
So this is an excellent incentive to encourage art students in Exoma to continue in their art form, but tell us about the competition.
Okay. They pick the first, the top three that they think would be more close to that team, for second and third prizes, and there'll be a drawing on Saturday to choose the winner. And then there's also an in-house the thing we have where you can select the picture that you like the most, and there'll be a drawing at the end of, on front and Saturday as well. Choose which picture get the most votes.
Okay,
so
now
we have the high school area, high school section, secondary, and primary school. And they put a lot of emphasis to that. You can see that they're very pictorial. They were very creative. I like it. But I wish more people would have entered the contest. So I have here, Collect Bear is one of the, things for the Bahamas. They even have the Bahamian dialect. And this is just done by a primary school student. It's just so funny.
The winner will be announced this Saturday, and we'll be there to capture the action.
And let me tell you, I went in there and looked around, and when I saw some of the artifacts that's in that museum, it brought back a lot of memory as a little boy growing up, and we spent much of our summers in Andros and seeing those things, and at one point I was like, somebody took my teacup and put it in there. But it's a wonderful experience in order to see that they preserve that. And there's a number of items too that they're now trying to gather and put in place to expand the library and give it another place where you can really go and see a lot of artifacts and history here down in Exuma. We're going to take another break. And when we come back, we're going to tell you that BTC is here again. We'll be right back, everybody.
Oh, when you come down, smiling faces over here, this welcome awaits you. Oh, when you get here, you hear them. Oh, no, we didn't know, say, summer sweet like this. Oh, no, we didn't know, say, summer sweet like that. Oh, no, we didn't know, say, summer sweet like this. Oh, no, we didn't know. Summer sweet like that. Jumbo is made up with his main line and keys. And still all these, there's no place like these. Southeast winds are blowing down Elizabeth Harbor. Oh, let me go, let me do the ling-a-ling. Oh, no, we didn't know. Summer sweet like this. Oh, no, we didn't know.
When you want the best seafood in Exuma, there's only one place to go. Shirley's Seafood Restaurant at the Fish Fry Queens Highway. Famous with Bahamians and tourists alike for creating exquisite Bahamian seafood dishes infused with international flavors. Be sure to try the Seafood Rice Bowl, Seafood Po' Boy, Coconut Grouper, Crispy Grouper Burger, and the Curry Conch. Shirley's Seafood Restaurant is open for lunch and dinner Thursday through Monday from 1 p.m. to 9 p.m. Call 242-422-3642 for more info or email them at shirleysseafoodfactory@gmail.com. Don't leave Exuma without dining at Shirley's Seafood Restaurant at least once or maybe more. You'll be glad you did.
ShopRite Mart in Georgetown, Exuma is the place where prices are the lowest and qualities the highest. ShopRite Mart can fill all your wholesale and retail grocery needs, from fresh fruits and vegetables, meats, dairy products, to groceries of all kinds, toiletries, drugs, and notions. ShopRite Mart has it all. Open Monday to Saturday from 8 a.m. to 7 p.m. and Sundays from 8 a.m. to 11 a.m. You can call them at 336-2670 or email them at shoprite@battelnet.bs. Remember, you're not shopping right unless you're shopping at ShopRite.
Centuries, Bahamians have been known as masters of the sea, from the Lucayans and Arawaks, swashbuckling pirates, quaint workboats to meticulously crafted sloop race boats. Bahamians have evolved the sport of sailing as it plays an integral part of our culture. For more than 70 years, Bahamians have displayed passion and grit for the sport, and it is one that has bridged the gap between young and older Bahamians. We are proud to anchor sailing as the national sport of the Commonwealth of the Bahamas.
You overpaying for low speeds with your internet provider? Stop wasting your money. Switch to BTC for the fastest internet to the most homes in the Bahamas. Get up to 300 megs fiber fast speeds, up to three times faster than what you get now. Plus, get 164 TV channels, all for just $42.50 a month for 12 months. That means you'll save $860 for the year. For the fastest speeds across the Bahamas and the lowest price by far, BTC is for you. Switch to the largest fiber network in the Bahamas.
Just feeling out, yeah. It's the I see now the break of dawn. Gone out of lightning and thunder. It was the darkest night. Gone out of lightning and thunder. It was the darkest night.
And welcome back, everybody, to beautiful Joyce on Exuma. We are poolside here at the wonderful Peace and Plenty. Guys are having some fun and watching the races, Class B out there. They were earlier watching the Class E and also the Class C. And so it's been a wonderful morning right here in Georgetown, Exuma, as we get the National Family Island Regatta up and rolling. Yesterday, we had the British High Commissioner on our program, and he spoke about the fact that there's a lot of youth-involved sailing programs around. And last night, he held a reception for many of the sailors and the skippers and the movers and the shakers. We also had an opportunity to have a word with the Governor General, His Excellency, and that is C.A. Smith, who was also down here. He had his cup race as well in the Class B, and he was out there watching. And so it was a wonderful expression as they are going to now engage in getting a number of our young people involved in sailing. And the British Sailing Association has taken an active role here, and the individuals who are into Olympic sailing and various kinds of sailing that they will be involved in. But these folks had a wonderful time last night. I want to say a very special thank you to all of the staffers that came out and made the place a wonderful time. And there's Danny Strawn. Danny had a date last night because I never seen that much starch in the shirt in my life. But he was out there and having a ball and had his hat on and all the other sailors and skippers. But it's great to have the British High Commissioner engaged with our youth sailing program. And also last night, he had a blast in the concert and had a wonderful time and meeting a lot of folks and going from there. And he said he'll be back over and over again. He's also planning to go to a number of regattas around the country. And so he gets a feel for what this is about. And what he likes is the passion that we bring to regattas. And people talk and smack, but in the end of the day, it's all about how they feel. Now, we have a young lady with us today who is named Stacy Mackey. She's from BTC. She was here yesterday, and I'm keeping my fingers crossed today that we're going to be okay, because that's why she's rocking with her here. And so keep your fingers crossed that everything go as planned. But she's the manager here for BTC, and she's been very busy. They have various stalls that's down in Regatta Park for those of you who need to top up very quickly and to do a lot of other things. And also, if you have packages that you want to get of that sort and go from there. But tell me, BTC in Exuma, how are you guys making it happen?
Listen, we are just happy to be here. We're happy to be supporting the National Family Island Regatta. This is their 67th year, and for us, we just feel privileged to be a part of it as one of the sponsors. We're having a fantastic time. I mean, the weather is incredible. The races have been very exciting. And so for us, we've been, you know, offering a lot of phone specials and deals. Mm-hmm. And we've been doing pretty well. We have a team, actually. We have a store that's here in Georgetown. And so, you know, we're just, it's a partnership where we're supporting them in their venture here at the National Family Island Regatta.
I also saw that you have your BTC truck.
Yeah.
And your van that runs around. And I'm like, got the generator on the back, got AC sitting in it so everybody can be comfortable. So you can take BTC to them.
That's right.
And so that works out very well from east to west.
Yeah, and you know, fiber is in some parts of Exuma. Mm-hmm. And so for us, we've been actually canvassing and speaking to persons who are interested in signing up for fiber. Right now, we have a 50% off discount that will end at the end of the month. So we have been promoting that. You know, just a fantastic time. Lots of great deals. We've had Exuma. We actually have a postpaid plan that's called Exuma. That's the $64.99 plan. And persons have been signing up there. I don't know if it's the excitement of being in Exuma, but we've been doing very well here. You know, persons patronizing our booth and so many activities going on as well.
I would notice a number of the visitors that came in as well, and some of the folks who are contemplating moving here to Exuma was talking to many of your sales reps about how they can ensure that they have telephone services and the cell phones and the product that you have, which are quality items. And I think the response for those have been very good.
Yes, yes, definitely. And inquiries were really amazing. Even this morning we got an inquiry about persons who are going to be here. There was a gentleman, he's going to be on his yacht. He's going to be here for like 2 months. plans, he said. So he was asking how we can get internet. So, you know, we're looking at all the different options. So it's exciting, I think, for persons to come out. When you talk about branding and being, you know, present in the communities in which you serve, I think we've done an excellent job here. I think almost everybody who's on the Regatta site is walking around with something that says BTC, you know, and I think for us that's very good. That's a good feat.
That's a good feeling, I would imagine, for you to see that so many folks are engaged and also asking questions and signing up to actually enhance and also utilize your product.
Yes, definitely. You know, we like to say that for us, it's important that we serve the communities in which we operate, but it's also important to have a good product and a good service. And, you know, we've been adamant about the fact that we want to reach everywhere. When you talk about the various family islands, not just Exuma, but all of the other family islands has a BTC presence. And that is very, very important to us because we know how the family islands, you know, we're sort of far flung in a way, you know what I mean? So being able to call, you know, WhatsApp is the thing now. So being able to call persons, being able to reach persons, it's not like how it used to be. I remember when I was in college, you know, there was no WhatsApp. No. You know, those phone bills were expensive.
You asking me? Okay. My daddy's still around, but he's still around that he got to pay this bill for to find out what we're doing.
You know, and you couldn't get a call every day. You know, you got a call probably like on a Sunday or something like that.
That's when he has a call. Yeah, there after you go. After eight, he done eat his dinner and everything else, he wants to know what's going on.
And you better be in place at 8 o'clock to when I call, right?
So you know. Mm-hmm. And so the historical intervention that BTC has in these islands and in the country is now coming together for you. And I see people are really gravitating to BTC.
Yes. And you know what? Like our senior leadership team, they've been going down to different islands. We've been to Andres. We've been to Lutra. You know, we're moving around and we want to touch our customers. We want to hear what they have to say and get feedback. And for us being here at the Exuma Regatta, I must say, fingers crossed, you haven't had any complaints. You know what I mean? But, you know, people love the service. We've grown up with BTC.
Right.
You know, we've known BTC from, you know, infancy to now. And it's been a great transformation seeing where we are now as a company and a brand.
Okay. And we have a partnership with you. And
yes,
and I'm proud about that. And this is an example of the phone that is up for grabs, okay, and with our promotional
attribute. Like, why are you trying to put me on the spot?
This is it. And she only bring one.
You know what? Let me show this one in the boxes. I don't want no foolish. So this is the one.
This is the one, okay?
Yes, this is the
one you can win. And so don't forget, you got to go to ZNSBahamas.com.
And we're selecting three winners to win the Samsung AO3 Core.
There you go. And let me tell you, it's a nice phone, too. Mm-hmm. Okay. This should be in my budget. So it's nice. But the bottom line is that this is a ongoing program. And once we would have come cleared out with Regattas, BTC will continue in its efforts to ensure that there is quality service given to the clients here in this area. And, hey, this is a long baby.
Oh, my God.
Exuma,
yes.
Exuma from east to west is a long way.
It is. I tried to drive to Baritari. I didn't make it. I had to turn back around. I didn't make it. But it's a beautiful island. Every morning I get up and I go for a walk on the beach. And I've done probably about 10 beaches so far. I actually was here from Thursday with the Kiwanis Club of the Bahamas. We came down for a division council meeting. So we would have been here last weekend doing some community service in the various schools, and then I just stayed over for Regatta. So, you know, I was lucky.
I'm glad you was able to send my friends back to Grand Bahama, Sabi and Spencer, and all those Kiwanians that came down. At least they got back home, and they're telling me that I need to go to these places that they was there. See what you caused? You caused them going to these places. Now they make me want to go to these places.
Listen, you know, being in a service organization, I think it's such an incredible thing because it allows you to give back. I think all of us give back to some extent. Like, someone's always asking, I'm hitting you up for a dollar, right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. But you know, you do it in a more organized setting. So for us, you know, being able to come down, and we have a Kiwanis Club of Exuma that exists here. So we came down and we supported them. Next up is Berry Islands.
Okay.
So we are making our way around to the various islands, and it's important. So we had 150 plus persons that came in from all the other islands down here to support the initiative that we were doing here in the community of Exuma.
Let me put you on notice.
Oh my gosh.
Zedna's going to the Berry Islands too.
When?
That's Vegan Needs, Vegan Needs, BTC. Okay, in order for us to get to the Berry Islands, yes. Mm-hmm. The Grand Bahama crew is going to go over there, and we're going to do a week over there in the Berry Islands, and BTC is our link to make sure we get that information out and everything happen. Don't worry, you're going to get the phone call.
Well, listen, I must say, I kudos to Zeniness. I think we've enjoyed quite a number of successful partnerships.
Mm-hmm.
You know, the Junkanoo Watch Party was just one of them, but we tend to work together, and I think that's good. When you have two Bahamian brands working together, you know, brands that people grow up with.
Right.
I grew up watching Zeniness. I mean, there was nothing else, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
I did the same thing. And then all of a sudden, I was into TV.
Yeah, really?
And I back into TV.
And you're doing a fantastic job, Regatta.
You only saying that because you want to take this phone.
Well, listen, I did bring you a gift. See, I did not come empty-handed. So, you know, I brought you this nice shirt. There you go. See?
Look listen at here.
Oh, there you go.
Listen here. That's ink. And that's the good fabric.
Of course, listen.
This is the good fabric.
And in addition to that,
what?
I brought all sure. of you and your whole team. You know, I want y'all to stay hydrated. Exuma is very hot. Did you tell them that Exuma is very hot?
Hold on. Bartender! Bartender!
Listen.
Please.
Okay, here, let me give you this one. So let me show you the beauty of it. It actually lights up. So when you're on the Regatta site at night, it's going to light up.
What?
Okay, so people are going to see you.
And the big concert tonight?
Oh, my gosh. Listen, They've already started.
This afternoon I was out there, and they were also dancing, and they were also singing.
Mm-hmm.
And I dared to go up on the stage.
Oh, my gosh. I think you could dance.
You think I can handle it?
I think you got some pep in your
step. We got 7,000 people here, and I can run 6. So, you know. But BTC, being in place, things are happening here in the Exumas, and I like what you guys are doing, and folks have you as a household word, and the service has been fantastic.
Yes, we've been getting a lot of compliments. Persons who, this morning at the Bahamas Air Flight, you know, a lot of persons came down and they were like, listen, we thought that we would have had a little drop in our calls or a little, you know, but they said everything has been perfect. The persons who have been here from last week from Nassau as well, they have been complimenting us about the service, no drop calls, you know, everything is working fine. So we're happy to know that.
Okay.
You know, that's very important to us.
Now, Regatta ends on Saturday.
Yes.
Okay?
Mm-hmm.
Make sure the technicians don't do no fool now. We got to keep these calls going because we got to call back for
it. Why are you like that?
I'm trying to make sure that the same attribute that is in mm-hmm. place now for Regatta.
It will continue.
It will continue for the entire year, because there's lots of festivals and other events that's going to be coming to Exuma. Lots of people coming in to start off new careers and also to find themselves new homes and all the other stuff, vacations.
Yes.
And all that kind of stuff. And they're going to come to you to say, I need to get some minutes and some time and some other kind of stuff. I just want to make sure that when they go out there in Elizabeth Harbor and they go across the Stockton Island, they get that signal and everything is working.
The same signal, the same service, everything will be working, I guarantee it. And I want to say this too, I just need to say this. We have been, in addition to selling our services and products, we've been having a lot of fun at our booth. We have a daily scavenger hunt,
mm-hmm.
and so we have persons that are going around the island and they're doing some fun stuff to know, you know, to familiarize themselves with Exuma.
Right.
So whether it's taking a photo of themselves at a government office with a Bahamian flag, a Bahamian dessert, they're moving around the island doing various things. And so, you know, we have persons who are going to be winning a phone, a Samsung device every day, as well as we have a domino tournament that is kicking off tomorrow.
Fantastic. So
yes.
You're keeping busy and everyone's making sure that they enjoy themselves, and BTC is doing what they do best.
There you go.
Run through the islands and make it happen in a unique manner. There's the phone. See that one there? I want that one right there. Okay. But it's great to see you, girl. It's good to, that we got through the whole scenario. And I know your staff is doing well. I love the van that you guys have that can move around and make some things happen and see how it goes. So for young Stacey Mackey, has it been good for you this week?
It has been incredible. Well, let me take that back. I think I spoke too quickly. I think I put on a few pounds. Uh-huh. And so that wasn't really good. Because, you know, the food here has just been so enticing. And I'm eating 3 meals a day. Usually I just eat 2 meals a day. But I don't know, something about being in Exoma, you know, I'm eating 3 meals a day. And I don't think that's a good thing.
Okay. I'm going to tell you what they're going to do to help you. We can let you walk behind the BTC bus.
Ricardo, really? You know, I do see I have my stepper on. So every day I am counting my steps. See where I'm at right now.
5,437.
Yeah, that's bad. In Nassau, I usually do...
You need to get to 10,000.
I know. That's my goal. 10,000 a day. And normally I try to exceed that. So I'm doing like 15. But you see where I'm at this time of the day. I feel ashamed.
It's 3:19. You walk the hill 7 times, all the way around.
Uh-huh.
Okay. All right. Go down by water's edge and come back around again.
But it's hot in this heat?
Yeah.
So you want me to collapse?
No. No. Romico got one straw hat. You can borrow you can borrow his straw hat and go from there.
But that's the fun part. I really taught you like to me. See,
yes.
Now I realize you don't like
yes,
me.
I'm making sure, okay?
By wearing that straw hat.
There you go.
Okay.
And you can be okay. So when you get back and you move around, they can say, who are you? They know.
Mm-hmm.
You're Miss Mackey.
Yeah,
okay.
There you go.
Thank you. It was a pleasure. And, yes, I kept my fingers crossed we're okay today.
Yeah,
where'd it go?
There they go.
BTC is here. And I'll tell you, great. And we're going to take another break. And when we come back, we'll continue. Bartender?
Sand dollar is a digital dollar created by the Central Bank of the Bahamas. It's just like physical cash, but safer and more convenient. Sand dollar is secure and can be used on any Android or ISO device. Use Sand dollar for your personal and business transactions. Whether by QR code or short name, you can send or receive Sand dollar safely with the touch of a button. Download any Sand dollar-enabled app to get started today. Sand dollar, it's just like texting cash.
Sometimes you need to make a classic move. That's why for all of life's moments, there's one classic credit card. Experience cashless purchasing power and chip and pin security with your RBC Visa Classic Credit Card. Manage your day-to-day expenses as well as life's little surprises. Apply today at rbc.com/Caribbean/Visa Classic and enjoy 1 year's free membership. Conditions apply.
Two Prime Spirits now has its newest location in Farmers Hill, Exuma. Need an ice-cold beer? How about some miniature wines, smooth rums and bourbons, or sparkling champagne? 242 Prime Spirits in Farmers Hill has all of this and so much more. Open Monday through Saturday, 9 a.m. to 6 p.m. Call them at 358-7055 to pre-order or with any special requests. Check out 242 Prime Spirits on Facebook and Instagram for more info or email them at 242primespirits@gmail.com. 242 Prime Spirits, now in Farmers Hill and Georgetown, for all of your beverage needs.
First we plan, then we innovate, then we build. At Bahamas Striping Group of Companies, we are committed to quality, to safety, and to service. We know that the road you take is just as important as your final destination. At Bahamas Striping Group of Companies, it is our job to make sure the road and the ride are as smooth as possible. From striping roads to building them, we are the right choice. The trusted choice, the only choice to help you build your tomorrow.
Welcome back, everybody, to beautiful Georgetown Exuma. We are live here at the Peace of Plenty Hotel. Yes, this is the 67th edition of the National Family Island Regatta. Much has happened here today. Started early this morning with the Class E sloops out there in the water, quite a few of those, and then they went into Class C. There's been a number of protests filed in Class C, and right now the Class B boats are on the water as well. We'll be able to hopefully get those results for you in just a tidbit, and then after that, at about, say, another 10 minutes, they're telling me they'll be the Class A sloops, and they're going to run back-to-back races, all because we had the bad weather yesterday, and we don't have that today. We have very good weather here in Elizabeth Harbor. The winds is up, and so it's going to be favorable as folks are gathering near the shoreline in order for that to happen. Now, earlier this afternoon, there was a very special race. This was a race that I sat here and I laughed at, because the challenge was made last night, and that is the Minister's Challenge. And yes, Minister Clay Sweeting, I. Chester Cooper, John Pinder out there, also Wayne Monroe, all took to the water and got on the tiller, and there they are sailing here in the challenge race. And so this was a pretty good one. The winds worked out, and the four sloops are moving in a very good manner. And there you can see the ministers there and the members of parliament on the actual tiller. But they're getting instructions about how to sail these boats, and these are the boats right now in the Class C. And so no harm, no foul. Nobody got into any kind of trouble. Nobody got lost at sea. None of the boats sank. Everything went exceptionally smooth for them. And as you can see, the maneuvers on the boat, they had a good time out there sailing, and they really enjoyed themselves. And if you know I. Chester Cooper, the DPM Minister of Tourism, he was not going to allow anybody to get away from him. This is his home water, and he did a very good job as he won the actual race earlier today. And congratulations goes out to him. And guess what? John Pinder. He's the member of parliament from South Abaco. He's also one of those Abaco sailors like Jeff Gale and those that grow up sailing. And they all had a wonderful time on the water, finishing second. And then Clay Sweeting. Yep. Clay got in there, buddy. He went in there and he showed him that he could also sail exceptionally well. And he was able to pick up a third place. And for coming in hot last. I mean, hot last, NASA Security Minister Wayne Monroe, who was talking smack last night that he's a Ragged Islander. They know how to sail in Ragged Island, and so that was another story. But that's what happened earlier today, having those guys on the water, and they really, in turn, had a very, very good time with that. And don't forget that they will be talking smack tonight and talking smack all day tomorrow in regards to what was happening out there in the water. And they, too, will be back later on in order to take a peek at what's happening as far as the Class A boats that will also sail in just a moment. We do also have with us a very special guest today. And come Tuesday, we saw a number of folks scurrying all the way around in order to get themselves all in place. And that is because Fidelity Bank is now getting ready to make a plunge here into Exuma and also regain its market share and come back. And when I went online, I saw that Fidelity was coming in. And with the Regatta, this is a very good introduction to Exuma. The Fidelity Bank is coming in. And Cresswell Gardner, who is one of the top individuals in Fidelity, the loans person. Now, you got the application for my loan? Okay, only kidding with you. But welcome to Exuma, and welcome to our show. Tell me, for you, getting Fidelity established here in Exuma and into the islands of the Bahamas is important to you.
Fidelity came into being as First Home Savings and Loan. We are turning 45 this year. Independence is 50 year. We're about to celebrate our 50th year independence. We've been in the community and from the community for the last 45 years. We've seen, and we've been troubled by, the amount of the other, what I call competitors, and how they've been largely retrenching from the Family Islands. We at Fidelity have decided that it is our responsibility as a Bahamian bank to bring banking to the people, right? As opposed to force the people to come to the banking. So earlier this year, we opened in Abaco, reopened in Abaco.
Right.
We're here in Exuma. We hope to open our doors this year in Exuma. Mm-hmm. And we are going to be looking at other opportunities in the family island where the demand is such. To respond to that need.
There is a great demand here in Exuma, and as we've seen with the kind of construction and things that's happening here, the town planning aspect of it was going on in terms of that, and people coming and going, and lots of visitors looking for means and ways to do some things. You picked the right time to venture into this market?
We have been testing the waters for the last year. We've had a way team coming up on a monthly basis, looking at business opportunity, meeting with, in fact, establishing banking relationships, even during this last 12 months.
Mm-hmm.
Me as an executive, this is now my ninth trip to Exuma in the last 12 months. My other executive colleagues have been here at least 20 times over that same period, various executives. So we're familiar with the island. We see that there is a need, not just for basic banking, but there are commercial opportunities in the space with tourism and these timeshare and getting Bahamians, the locals, to actually own a piece of the rock, and that's something that we're looking to stand up also.
You did mention the fact that many of your competitors are running from the islands, and you're running to the islands now in terms of Fidelity. What pushed that?
Our mandate goes beyond purely profit, mm-hmm. right? As a Bahamian bank, that is Bahamian-centric, right? We feel our fortune is tied with our people. And this notion that the bank should be disconnected from its people by essentially forcing them along a path, and what I call dragging them along, mm-hmm. right? Fidelity's approach is simple. Where my people are, there I'll be. And so our focus is the people are here in Exuma. Look at the island. It's buzzing, right? Not just because of Regatta, but despite Regatta. I mean, you come here next month, it's humming. And so our view is we ought not force Exumians to have to jump on a plane, jump on a boat, mm-hmm. to come to Nassau in order to conduct commerce, right? We will offer a suite of service and product on the island that allow people to remain in place and hopefully stimulate the local economy.
It's amazing that you mentioned that, because I had a conversation with a businessman on the dock when they were taking the boats off, and he was talking about some of the headaches that they have here in Exuma with simple functions in terms of banking of sort, you can't get anything done. You have to turn around and run to New Providence, and it's really difficult at times. And with you coming in and bringing Fidelity here, it brings some comfort, I believe, to the Exumians that's going to be able to do business with you.
No, we've heard the cry, and we know it's a real need, all right? I mean, there's not a time when this Fidelity shirt hits the road, someone doesn't approach to ask about the service, whether that is commercial credit, whether that is merchant service activities, simple borrowing and deposit account relationships. The island really has a need for service. And again, not all of the services are money making, profit generating activity, right. But the reality is we've got to cater to the whole banking need and not just simply focus on those things that only make the bank money.
I know in Grand Bahama, that's my your bank is my mother's bank, and you find that people have given you very good reviews in regards to what happened. I think in the same vein, that's what you want to see happen here, that the Exumans can find confidence in a bank that's going to provide all the services necessary.
Absolutely. You heard me reference earlier, we came into being as First Home Savings and Loan. What we want, really, the folks from Exuma, those who are not homeowners, to own their first home,
mm-hmm.
right? Those who have never owned a lot, own their first lot. Those who need to stand up their first business, we want to be the bank that actually put the customer first, right? And so We expect to roll out products, programs that's going to be catered and geared at getting our customers and the community, quite frankly, first and foremost.
Well, having the Regatta as an introduction as far as Fidelity and its movements and coming here into Exuma, the time frame, according to the folks I've spoken to, you guys got to move quickly because it's very difficult for a lot of folks to do business here in Exuma. And you can see all these little small businesses that are all over the place. And as simple as getting a transaction done is kind of hard. And so you guys are going to have your work cut out for you.
My CEO, Gowan, Bo, Greg, Bethel, myself, we came down last year and met with the Chamber of Commerce, business community, and made a commitment that this year we will open doors. And we plan to fulfill that commitment. We've already identified two locations. We're in the advanced stage. Just one location we have already began to outfit. And so we expect very soon to reveal the where and the suite of services that we hope to offer the community.
I saw over at the Regatta site you have your table and flags, so people are stopping by getting information in regards to the services that Fidelity will be bringing here to Exuma. And folks are stopping by and they're eager to find out exactly what you're going to be bringing to the game.
We are encouraged by the amount of persons who stop by our tent. All right, and what we want is feedback. Right? Mm-hmm. To say, yes, this bank is offering this, right? So we have a suite of services that we plan to offer. But there might be unique island needs for Exuma that those like me, the executives in New Providence, may be out of touch with,
right?
And the purpose of our setting up that tent is to encourage local feedback to say, these are my needs. And what we are in being a Bahamian bank is that we don't have Canada or the U.S. to report to, right? Our head office sits on one floor in Nassau, all Bahamia, right? So I could take that information back and we can sit down within an hour, come up with a product that is catered to the needs of the folks in Exuma.
Providing a personal service is essential, and we've seen it with many of the other institutions. They don't want you to come inside, they don't want you to do this, they don't want you to do that, but you are providing a personal service to the people, not just here in Exuma, but the people of the Bahamas.
Exactly the point, right? This notion that, again, bank believe that the whole economy and banking services should be all remote or all digital, we're in a different space, right? Those customers who want to have a face-to-face experience and an encounter, those of our parents who are elderly and perhaps not necessarily tech savvy, who need to have a different experience, our view is that we will meet our customers where they are and hopefully move them forward progressively, but do so in a way that actually encourages them rather than pushes them towards.
Good. This is not all business for you. What has been your take on the Regatta?
Listen, I am here for, they will tell you I lead the social committee. Right, so okay. While I'm here, I'm planning carnival next month. Right, so there's never a time I see a boat and water or green grass.
Okay,
so I've been toggling between the Regatta site and these boats. I've got four boats in the water, so to speak.
Go on record.
I go on record as saying I have four boats in the water.
Okay, four boats in the water.
So when I look at Chester and Co., those DPM and the ministers on the boat moments ago, I can tell you the one who I didn't have in the water, right? Finish in the bottom two.
I'm gonna leave that exactly where you have it. But I do know that Fidelity will make a great impact here, and you can see Clayto's working it, and there's DPM. He's got the tiller and making it happen, and so he knows the water very well. And so this is the kind of things that Regattas bring. I think this is a great selling point for Fidelity to come down and be engaged and involved in this kind of atmosphere, and it'll stick in people's minds that this bank is coming to Exuma. And then when they leave Exuma, many of these folks will be going back, and they'll be looking at, you know, they interested in my people at home. And so I may have a different outlook as to what I may want to do when I get to New Providence or when I get into Grand Bahama or even in Abaco, where people have banks they have to deal with and looking for a facility that's going to make them comfortable.
Absolutely. Absolutely. This is the first regatta that we sponsored. So Fedele came on as a sponsor, mm-hmm. and we were happy to do so. Next month we're in Andrus for Crab Fest,
okay.
That we're sponsoring. And so, like I said, we're about community building,
right.
and not just simply transactions.
Okay. I'm going to get your number before you leave because we're still trying to build Grand Bahama Regatta. We don't know what can happen with that. But Shavita, we contact you. Yeah. And so we'll see how it goes. But I want to wish you much success. I understand that it is a difficult road in terms of coming in as a new person on the block and gaining confidence of the residents and also people that will be moving back home to Exuma. And I met a lot of folks who are intending to move back home. And by the time you get here, they'll be ready to come back, and it should be okay in terms of having their facility, banking facilities in place so they can do business with you.
Love to be here, and we are here for the long haul.
There you go, folks, and there you have it, Mr. Christwell Gardner. 45 years celebration of birthday. When is the birthday party?
In May.
Right around the corner.
It's right around the corner.
Okay, in May. Let me see what we need from Fidelity in May. Okay, I'll message you.
Now be reminded that normally when you're having a birthday, somebody bring you gifts.
That's my point. And so, hey, listen, we're coming for the party.
Indeed.
We're coming for the party. And I know the banks will be celebrating throughout the country. And it's an awful good thing to, in order to introduce Fidelity here at the time as you move into the 45th year and celebrate growing the Bahamas and growing as a banking institution.
Absolutely.
There you go. Thank you for sitting here with us. When we come back, we'll tell you exactly what's happening here in beautiful Exuma. Guys are having a ball and things are here. We're going to be back, so stay with us. My
important thing in life is family. And whenever you need reliable advice, you look to the people you know you can trust. At J.S. Johnson Insurance Agents and Brokers, we earn our clients' trust every day. Whether it's home, motor, travel, or commercial insurance, we've got you covered. Call 397-2100 or visit jsjohnson.com.
J.S. Johnson Insurance. Peace of mind.
I'm hurt.
Mix. Available at all your favorite liquor stores. Remember to drink responsibly.
We get up early every morning to offer safe and dependable service. Where quality service is paramount. An excellent travel experience is priority. Connecting the islands of the Bahamas to the world. Bahamas Air. We don't just fly here, we live here.
242 Prime Spirits in Georgetown, Exuma is your one-stop shop for all your beverage needs. From ice-cold beers to wines to rum and sparkling champagne. They've got everything. Open Monday to Thursday, 9 a.m. to 6 p.m. and Friday, Saturday, 9 a.m. to 7 p.m. Call 242 Prime Spirits at 336-3728 or WhatsApp 823-9388 for special requests, to pre-order, or for delivery. Be sure to ask for Magnolia or Kelly. And check out their Facebook and Instagram pages at 242 Prime Spirits for more information. That's 242 Prime Spirits, Georgetown, Exuma, and now at Farmers Hill for all your beverage needs.
When you want the best seafood in Exuma, there's only one place to go. Shirley's Seafood Restaurant at the Fish Fry Queens Highway. Famous with Bahamians and tourists alike for creating exquisite Bahamian seafood dishes infused with international flavors. Be sure to try the Seafood Rice Bowl, Seafood Po' Boy, Coconut Grouper, Crispy Grouper Burger, and the Curry Conch. Shirley's Seafood Restaurant is open for lunch and dinner Thursday through Monday from 1 p.m. to 9 p.m. Call 242-422-3642 for more info or email them at shirleysseafoodfactory@gmail.com. Don't leave Exuma without dining at Shirley's Seafood Restaurant at least once or maybe more. You'll be glad you did.
This show is sure and come down. Smiling faces over here. This welcome awaits you. Oh, when you get here, you hear them. Oh, no, we didn't know.
And welcome back, everybody. We are live here in Georgetown, Exuma, and we are now looking at the Class A sloops that's lining up, and they are going to start racing in just a moment. They're going to sail back-to-back races. Again, yesterday, treacherous winds created a situation that in turn forced the boats to actually have to come back in, and they called the race off for safety reasons in doing so. So they'll have two races here for Class A. Also keep in mind, too, that later on this afternoon at about 6 o'clock, we will have the ceremony to name sailing as the actual national sport of the country. Our broadcast will in turn be carrying it live at 8 o'clock tonight. We have the opening ceremonies, and we will have Priceville Forbes, Executive Chairman of the Broadcasting Corporation, as your master of ceremony. Then the Royal Bombers Defense Force will do the band, will do the actual national anthem. Reverend Joseph Brown will in turn give us a prayer. That's the owner of Ed Sky. The Honorable Leonardo Lightborn, Palm Secretary of Ministry of Agriculture, Marine Resources, and Family Island Affairs will bring the welcome tonight. And then the Honorable John Pender, Parliamentary Secretary of Ministry of Tourism and Investments and Aviation, will bring remarks. That'll be followed by the Honorable Mario Boleg, the Minister of Youth, Sports, and Culture. Then we'll also hear from the Honorable Clay Sweeting, who is the Minister for Agriculture, Marine Resources, Family Island Affairs. And then also we'll hear from Mr. Chester Cooper, Chester Cooper, who is Deputy Prime Minister, Minister of Tourism, who will also bring remarks and will introduce the Prime Minister, Honorable Philip Brave Davis, who will also do the unveiling and officially make sailing and then junkanoo after we finish, and we can make junkanoo the ultimate culture as well, the national culture of the Bahamas. But that's a little of the program. Danny Strawn with me here today. Also, you've been a busy man all day.
Extremely busy. Yesterday.
Okay.
We're trying to make sure that we get all of our races in today.
Okay, because tomorrow it's final day, right. So you don't want to have to run that many races tomorrow, because
right.
then you have to turn around and then begin to get these boats back out of the water
right.
and then get them ready on their trailers. They have to get them back to where they need to go as far as getting them on the barge.
Precisely.
And so that's going to be a good one. But tell me about tonight. Well, very important ceremony.
Tonight is very historic for the country, and we're so happy that after so many years, we're now moving to the next pillar of our country, which is our national sport. Everybody's been calling for change in terms of crooked being the national sport. I know personally, not that I want to take all the credit for it, I've been crying for it for about 25 years, and I'm so happy and ecstatic that we've reached that point now whereby it will be officially the national sport of our country, sailing, that is.
Okay. You will have the members of Parliament here, many of the ministers, the Honorable I. Chester Cooper, who is right from this area, and the Minister of Tourism. He will bring remarks and introduce the Prime Minister, the Honorable Philip Brave Davis. And also we'll have the Minister of Agriculture, Marine Resources and Family Island Affairs, the Honorable Clay Speedy, would also bring remarks. And sailing is going to be placed in his ministry, but then turned over to the local government aspect of it. And so there are still some adjustments to be made, I gather, in terms of how they set up the regatta desk and all these other kinds of things.
Right.
But as far as you're concerned, sailing is it.
Right. I think they really need to appoint a commission to really, manage and see that sailing truly gains the kind of, prominence that we need in our country. Because you just don't declare it as a national sport and do nothing else. I think we also need to educate our people, not just Nassau-centric, but throughout the entire country. And we made a very film called, See How the Mainsail Set. And the intention behind that was to make sure that when sailing do in fact become the national sport, it will be a teaching tool, not only for just the schools, but the entire country.
Mm-hmm.
And that message needs to go throughout the entire country and make sure that the people understand what new national sport is and why is it a new national sport and how it's important it's going to be to the country itself.
Okay. There are many facets of sailing.
Internationally.
And we spoke earlier about it. And so there are a lot of windows that sailing can open. Not just for those seasoned sailors, but you can open windows for junior sailors who could do some things. Because you could get some guys who could be at the Olympic level very quickly in various types of sailing, and that could work out well.
Yeah, we really want to, hopefully a result of this now being the national sport, we can probably have another do it nodes or several do it nodes.
Mm-hmm.
We have our Golden Boys and our Golden Knights. So that's what we're working towards with sailing. And the important thing, Ricardo, is the fact that young Bahamians now can get scholarship to go off the schools in the United States, wherever they want to go, through sailing. So that is some of the benefit of having, your sailing as our national sport.
Right.
And I think it has to be supported, by the government. Not only the government, but also I think the private, companies need to get involved too. They also need to get involved and help us, to move the sport along in order to give our young skippers and sailors the opportunity not only just to compete, but also to get an education in the process.
And I think that can happen. And I'm talking to Michael earlier, a good friend of yours, and he said, you have where guys like Stefan and those are given opportunities to go off and go to Boston and do some other things. Our kids will get the same opportunity. We have a lot of kids that's getting that opportunity now to do certain things, whatever. But those individuals are now learning sailing, like here in Exuma, in the e-boats and whatnot, so you can move up in that regards. In New Providence and Grand Bahama, we have the lasers and the other small little boats that we could use, and they are bigger boats.
Precisely.
And that you can also gravitate to with the Olympic and world prominence. So that opens up a door. And then, too, Danny, we got all kind of water. And so in all these islands, we can engage in getting sailing in Eleuthera and Auckland and Crooked Island, Long Key, Salvador, Mayaguana. And all it takes is a little bit of time and investments by individuals. And then, too, in those islands, like these guys who are here on the sloops and come to see the sailing, that brag that they could sail, they could also teach.
Of course.
folks how to sail.
That is the object. Because we, you know, in Exuma, we formed a junior sailing school, and that has been done wonders, you know, for the young people here in Exuma. And as I said to many people, it can be a template for the rest of the Bahama Islands to teach their kids how to sail. Mm-hmm. And not only that, get opportunities, you know, to educate themselves through sailing. And so that's why, you know, this being our national sport is going to have a tremendous impact throughout the country. And I'm so happy that it's being done here at the National Family Island Regatta.
Sailing is a sport that requires, you think?
Discipline.
And discipline, okay? Right. You don't have to be 6'9" right. in order to bounce a ball and be able to walk and chew gum.
Right.
It's just a matter of being able to use your natural ability
skills
in order to know how to maneuver the boat in order to get from one point to the next and then to go from there. And then also currents, winds, and that kind of stuff.
Right.
And so you're using all your faculties, and it could work. You could be 5'1". Mm-hmm. And be a champion sailor, or you could be 6'4" and be a champion sailor.
Right, precisely. That's the beauty of it. You know, Raleigh Gray ran his last race when he was 80 plus. You know, that tells you he's skilled. You know, sometimes, you know, strength is important. But, you know, that skill and ability to think and read the wind is so important. It's like tennis. Oh, this race is starting now.
There you go. Class A sloops are getting ready to run up. But tell me, how is that going to work, Danny, when they finish the race, they just stay on the boats.
On the boats and go back.
And come right back to the starting line.
Right.
Okay, will Clyde open the course or will he shut it down?
No, the course will remain open.
Okay.
Yeah.
I know we want to make sure that folks had to see the beauty of the A class so you can see how they sail. And that's a lot, all that floating flotilla out there that is moving along with the boats in order to see how they sail.
Right.
And see how skillful these skippers are in terms of getting their boats to move in and get around. And you can see the scales. The sails are coming up now.
Right.
And then we're looking for a position, and the wind's now becoming a factor.
Right.
You can see now some of the boats are now following each other and making that eastern turn. And some are going to come up into the bay, and some are going to go out in a unique manner. And you got to know how to read the wind.
Right.
And go from there.
Yep.
And so that's going to be a good one. And it's beautiful to see these boats lay out and be able to move out to the buoy and then come back around.
Right. Okay. Adam, I have to get on the water. Sorry.
I can see you later on, right?
Right. Okay. Thank you so much.
Great. I'm going to see you later on, Danny.
Thank you so much.
Danny's going to have to get it right. Go ahead, Danny. Go. Take it off and go on. Danny Danny got to get out of here. He says he's got to go to the A boats, and he wants to get on the water because he wants to see these races back to back. And so that's going to be a wonderful experience. You can see the boats there making their way out, and a whole fleet of the A-class boats that's on the water. And they are looking exactly beautiful in terms of how they are moving to the buoys. And we have 8 of the A-class boats that's on the water now and sailing a beautiful race at that. And so, folks, this is what you come to Exuma for the sailing extravaganza. And that's exactly what this A-class is giving us. The defending champion out there as well, and so we'll see how they're able to fit into the mix and to go from there. We're going to take a break, and then when we come back, we will tell you who's leading and who did what here in Georgetown, Exuma.
Welcome awaits you. Oh, when you get here, them. Oh, no, we didn't know. Say, some are sweet like this. Oh, no, we didn't know. Say, some are sweet like that.
Let the people know where to stay.
ShopRite Mart in Georgetown, Exuma is the place where prices are the lowest and qualities the highest. ShopRite Mart can fill all your wholesale and retail grocery needs, from fresh fruits and vegetables, meats, dairy products,
to groceries of all kinds, toiletries, drugs, and notions. ShopRite Mart has it all. Open Monday to Saturday from 8 a.m. to 7 p.m. and Sundays from 8 a.m. to 11 a.m. You can call them at 336-2670 or email them at shoprite@batelnet.bs. Remember, you're not shopping right unless you're shopping at ShopRite.
And welcome back, everybody, here to beautiful Georgetown, Exuma, the Class A sloops on the water. Ed Sky, good news, new courageous, the new legend, Red Stripe, Rough Justice, Running Tide, and Tidal Wave. They will sail two incredible races here this afternoon. You can see the flotilla, as many have gone out just to see these boats and see how they are going to sail out here today. And before we do leave you, we are letting you know that you are watching coverage of the National Family Island Regatta here in Georgetown, and it's also time to give you a Big Splash Regatta giveaway code word. Remember now, once you see the code word, you have to go to ZNSBahamas.com, where you have to now enter the code and your information. As soon as you've got all of the codes for today, you will in turn be able to be our big winner. And here we go. Here's the code for you. There it is. That's your code. And remember now, this is our Big Splash Regatta giveaway code. And right now, go to ZNSBahamas.com, enter the code word and your information. And when you have got all three of our daily words and codes, you can then win some big prizes. We had earlier BTC here with some cell phones they're going to be giving away. Also, cases of Cooper Blueberry. And also, we're going to have you getting some free credit to your son dollar card or wallet. And then also, you can get a ThinkPad, the courtesy of Security Depot. Just remember, get that word in and get that code in, and then put your information in, and you could be a big winner. And it's going to be fun. Don't forget also that tonight we're going to have the official ceremony here at Regatta Park for the naming of sailing as our national sport. The Prime Minister, the Honorable Philip Brave Davis, will officially make and unveil the model in terms of sailing. The Honorable I. Chester Cooper, Deputy Prime Minister, will also bring remarks and introduce the Prime Minister. We will also hear from the Honorable Clay Sweeting, who will tell us about sailing in his ministry. And also we'll hear from the Minister of Sports, the Honorable Mario Boleg, the Honorable John Pinder, Parliamentary Secretary, Ministry of Tourism and Investment. And also we'll be hearing from the Honorable Leonardo Lightborn, who is also Parliamentary Secretary, Ministry of Agriculture and Marine Resources and the Family Islands. And we'll have Pricewell Forbes, Executive Chairman of the Broadcasting Corporation, as our MC tonight. And the Reverend Joseph Brown will also bring the opening prayer. So we have a full ceremony set tonight, and we'll be able to give you much of that right here on the ZNS television and radio network. Ceremony is set to start, or actually pre-show is at 6 o'clock, with a full ceremony set to start at 8 o'clock tonight. It's been a wonderful day here in Georgetown, Exuma. Coming up tomorrow is our final broadcast here, regatta time, and it's going to be great. We will be hearing from a number of players, and we'll be hearing from some of the skippers and the movers and shakers, and finding from them how this whole week has gone, and why this particular regatta, the 67th National Family Island Regatta, is such a draw in terms of coming here to beautiful Georgetown, Exuma. We leave you with the Class A sloops as they are going through Series Race 1, and then they'll go back to the starting line for Series Race 2, and then it's trash talking come tomorrow in Series Race 3. It's been a wonderful day on behalf of the entire team here in Exuma, our radio personality as well, Hope Shelly Ann, and all of us here. Thank you guys for being with us. We'll be back tomorrow at 2 o'clock and giving updates as to what's happening here in beautiful Georgetown, Exuma. So long, everybody.
All the electronics you need are at Security Depot. Laptops, cameras, speakers, TVs, drones, video games, and so much more are here at Security Depot. Check us out at the mall at Marathon to see our wide selection, or visit us online at securitydepot242.com.